Hi YouTubers, welcome back to my next video. In this video we are going to see some of the important tips and in Excel sheet. So without wasting time, let us start. So what we are going to see today is this Excel. So how to create this kind of module. So how to create this kind of charts with the sheets, with the entries you have done here. So basically it's a small thing where I have entered some of the details, some names, date of birth, details, and everything. I have mentioned it, and this is mainly used for the abroad education. The people who are using a small industry, they can use this Excel as their leads generation and what's happening with their leads. So this is the student details, where you can able to see all the student details, date of birth, passport number and mobile number, his and student qualifications. You can able to see the small qualifications what he have done and all, and the percentage and the backlogs, and abroad details, which country he is interested. You can able to see that here there is a drop down menu. How to create this drop down menu we will be going to see. Okay, and here is the university and the course and the company required details, the status and which state we have applied, and date of application which we have received, and who is dealing that file. So everything here is a drop down menu kind of thing. And then here comes your financials, your bank name, type of funds, amount and date of amount. And this is the course fees. So course fees is like how much is the course fees of the particular university he has applied for the particular course, and you will be getting all these details and if any scholarship is present or not. So this is how the table looks like, and these are the some details in front of you. Let me fastly fill one of the details, like here it is a format kind of thing is there. So what I have done here is you need to select this all row, particular row. You need to particular low you this format cells, you need to select it, and here it comes your date kind of thing. So in which format you require your date, you can select it here as well. Okay, so this is how you can select it, and it can be, I have selected here is this guy, this format. So you just press on OK. So however you write it, it will be coming like this. Let me start with its month. Of date of birth is like 07 01, and if it is 1993, then you just enter it. It's 1st July 1993, and the passport number, there is no evaluation kind of thing passport number. And for email ID there is a one more evaluation kind of thing. So what you can do for this total kind of thing, I am doing it for cell, you can do it for the total entire row. You can go here for data, you can go for data validation. So in this data validation, this is the small code which I have written. I will be zooming it out, and you will be able to see. This is a small thing. What I have done is I am searching for an @rate, at symbol, and one dot symbol, and if there are any spaces. So if there are any spaces, then I am giving an error kind of message. The error alert will be do you want to continue? Yes. Okay, the error alert will be this kind of thing, and just you place it out here. Okay, so now let me type one email ID. Okay, man@gmail.com. As soon as it doesn't recognize any @rate or dot symbols, then it will give an error message. The email address should contain this. If you press retry, then it will be here itself. Again, if you do it, and if you press enter, if you cancel it also, it will be cancelled at any cost. The employee or the person who is entering this Excel should enter a valid email address, so where you know the details. This @rate and dot should be must and should, and there should not be any spaces. So I am giving a general email ID, so abc@abc.com. So it will take, and the mobile number here. You can give your mobile number validation also. I'll show you how to give your mobile number validation. Go to data validation, go to here, a whole number. Equal to 10. Okay. So here I have not given any error alert. So I need to give an error alert. You can give an error message, mobile number must be 10 digits. Okay, or you can go to this comma. Whole number equals to, not equals to, value should be 10. Apply. Okay, so here you go. The data validation is not working. I'll update you afterwards. So let me paste some values right now. JNTUH, a percentage, any percentage, number of backlogs. So which country here, if you require which this kind of drag down box, then what you need to do is, see here you can't find drop down box. Here it is, here it is, here it is, here there is no drop down box. So what you need to do, you need to go here and then data validation. You need to select your data validation. Here you need to select the list, and then here you need to click it. So this is a country, so you should previously you should have this list. What are the things it should be, it should have, then it will get your sheet number from this to this, and this is here. Okay, so now you have got your school drop down box. Okay, so it will not take any entries again, it will are the same thing. So its user need to select it. So this is how they do. Okay, now let us go here and let me click it. So hope you have got it, how to apply today, how to get this drop down box. Okay, so same thing applies here. Okay, this is the seventh month, so no, it's fourth. So 04/07/2019. So today date, and let me make it very fast. The staff name, who is dealing, and other details you can fill it later. So this is how it works. And then to get this cool thing, let me delete it first. Yes, so now what you can go here is insert. You need to select it first of all, which are the which on which data you want this to be happen. So on which data you need to select it, then go with pivot table. Here the sheet you have see, you will be seeing the sheet A. This is the A column from 3rd to your X. x, this is the 21st column, till 21st it has taken the data which is present in this, it has collected, okay? And if you press it okay, then you will get it here. Now what I want with this data, number of students have applied for different universities I want. So number here, there are different universities, so to which university, how many people they have applied I require. So what I will be doing is, here the university I have got here and the number of students I require I have got here. So in this, how many students have got their offer and they have got everything, if you want, then there is a status column which you can keep it here, filter, and you can able to see there are many things present here who have got, you have not got their offers. If you want to see, see conditional offer received, financials yet to apply, you have not applied yet till now. So how many people are there? So this many peoples are need to be yet to apply, we need to apply for this many people. So you can have this individually, student name and details, everything one by one here. Okay, so everything, it's a serial number 8 and this is a thing data. You can always have this kind of master in Excel, this kind of things. Okay, so how many people have done how many files, if you want to know staff name, you can place it here. Dinesh has done one for this, Leela has done one for CQ, you can able to see. This is a staff report, staff reporting you can able to see. Okay, for this staff reporting, if you want a pie chart kind of thing, then you can have your pie chart kind of thing. So Dinesh, how much he has done here, this we need to remove it, and staff name, every staff name we have applied it here. So let me remove the filter, and you can able to see this many students, overall performance of our company. Daud has only done your CQU IIBT. I want to show which field he is asking. So you need to see the university, the number of students he has done. So staff name, I have got it here, and here it is, this thing. So it's a two dimensional thing. So you can see directly. Let me remove this and let me show you a 2D diagram where you can able to see for this university how many things we have applied. So this will be a two dimensional thing, and you have more three dimensional also we have. So for three dimensional data, then we require different kinds of things. So let me see with other charts, surface, bubble, all type of charts, you can have different types of charts here. From this you can go ahead and you can select any kind of chart, and then you can have the data. See, this is how you got the data. So it's best right now for me, for this data, this is the best thing. So how many people, how many data they have got, okay, how many, how much we are doing. So not only this data, I can able to show you many things. As I told you, which staff has done how many things, so this is how you can able to find. Now this dealing with two students, Dinesh is dealing with three students, and how many students are dealing with how many students. I can get it clearly. Okay, so for this again I can have our column layout kind of thing, and then who is struggling a lot. Raj is struggling a lot. He is handling about 7 students, we can able to see. So he has a prospective data of 7, so you need to convert. So this is how you can able to analyze everything, every student, and this Excel might be useful to you. I will provide this Excel in the link in the description. If you like this video, please like it, share with your friends, and if there are any doubts, and if you are doing any kind of business there, you want to create one Excel, and if you are facing any problem, then you can always contact me. I'll easily help you out how to do it and how to solve the problem. And if you want any Excel to be created and to be given to you, then I am very much be glad to help you out and make you in that particular Excel, and then I'll provide you. Hope you have liked this video. Signing off. Thank you for watching.